Good evening from the Frank Lavac Memorial Coliseum. This is Silver Eagle Basketball. I'm Steve Martinelli, and tonight the MG boys playing host to the Monroe Cheesemakers in a Badger Conference South matchup. MG comes into tonight's game with a 6-1 conference record, good for first place, tied with Stoughton. 11-4 overall, much better than the Cheesemakers, who are 2-5 in the conference, 7-9 overall. And looking to right their ship, Cheesemakers have had trouble scoring points all season, averaging under 43 a game. They've been held to less than 35 four times this season, and that's going to be a big problem for them tonight as the Silver Eagles play good defense but manage to score some points. Monona averaging about 53 a game. Monroe comes into the game. Their leading scorer, Ben Latimer, averaging 11.3 a game. Latimer, a huge kid. Honorable mention all-conference offensive lineman. I can certainly pick him out of a crowd as the lineman of the bunch. It's a monstrous kid, but I think the Silver Eagles had some athletes inside who can handle him, and Joel O'Donnell and Jackson Riley. Let's talk about Monona Grove's scoring for a minute. O'Donnell and Riley have both played well in the post this year. Joel averaging a little over 8 points a game. Jackson about 6.5. Monona getting some points on the outside from Miles Thomas and Zach Stinson, both averaging over 8 points a game. Mitch Kelsey has come on really strong this season. They average 6 a game for Monona Grove. And one thing I like is the Silver Eagles have all sorts of outside shooting threats. They've got 9 different players who've hit 3-point shot this year. Zach Stinson, leader among those with 13, unofficially, of course. Silver Eagles coming off two straight wins. Madison Edgewood on the 29th, and then on the 31st, the Burlington Demons came here and went home with a loss. Silver Eagles winning that one, 58-33. A nice game for Monona Grove, 3 players in double figures. Miles Thomas leading the way with a career-high 19 points. 11 for Mitch Kelsey. I mentioned Mitch earlier. He's been playing really well. And then Joel O'Donnell, the muscle in the middle with 10 points. O'Donnell's going to have his hands full with Latimer. Latimer averaging just over 11 a game, but he had a high of 29 against Dodgeville. Also leading the way for Monroe this season, Logan Weckerly, a 6'3 senior with 7.4 points a game, and Alex Tordorf, a 5'10 sophomore, averaging 8 a game. Tordorf, their second leading scorer on the season, he had a high of 13 against Dodgeville. They don't have a lot of high individual scorers. Latimer's the only one to break the 20-point barrier, but to be honest, the Silver Eagles haven't either this season. They just got a lot of kids coming off the bench, a lot of athletic kids coming off the bench who can score some points, who can play some defense, get some rebounds. And they don't have a problem defending them, a bigger player like Latimer. Latimer is a big load, but I got a lot of confidence in the MG post players. We're just about ready for player introductions. And, of course, it's teacher night tonight where the Silver Eagle players get a chance to point out their most inspirational teacher. I think it's a tradition I really like. Good for the players, good for the teachers, and good for the fans to see who's doing a good job here at the high school. First for the Cheesemakers. Number 3, Jacob Flannery, a 5'10 senior. Number 5, sophomore Tyler Elmer. Maybe not. Number 10, Desmond Ford, a 5'8 senior. 21, senior Kevin Noriega. 25, Alex Tordoff. And 42, Ben Latimer. So basically, 4 guards and Latimer. Now the Silver Eagles starting lineup. Six-one senior, number 14, Nick Meyer. 6'3" junior, number 24, Joel O'Donnell. Number 22, 6'4" senior, Jackson Riley. 5'10" junior, number 23, Miles Thomas. 6'2 senior guard, number 3, Zach Stinson. Stinson, Meyer, Riley, Thomas, and O'Donnell for the Cheesemakers. Flannery, Ford, Noriega, Tordoff, and Latimer. Weckerly either injured or coming off the bench. So the Silver Eagles with a decided height advantage. Latimer the biggest man on the floor, but the rest of the Silver Eagles tower over the Cheesemakers. All right, and here we go. The tip to the Cheesemakers. Thomas slapping it to Joel O'Donnell. Monona Grove will have the first possession of the evening. Meyer faked the three. He'll pass it out to O'Donnell, left side. Thomas up top. Stinson, right side, Thomas for three, long. Rebound, Tordoff. Tordoff will bring it up for the Cheesemakers. This is Flannery, back into the middle to Ford. Trying to drive by, and Meyer ran into some trouble. Hands off to Noriega. Now on the switch, Meyer has him again, up top to Tordoff. Latimer, left side. Flannery, Tordoff up top. Ford to Flannery. Noriega for three. Nope. Stinson slapped it away from Latimer, but stepped on the line. It'll be Monroe ball. Tordoff doing the honors, inbounding. Riley's drawn Latimer to start the game here. They probably ran into each other on the football field. All right, now we're ready to go. Tordoff looking to inbound. Ford for three. Nope. Rebound Riley. He's on the run. Leading the break. Now he'll pull up. Hit Stinson. Into the corner to Miles Thomas. Back to Stinson. And a foul call. A blocking foul called on Desmond Ford. His first foul. Pat Murphy, the coach of Monroe, wants a charge called on Stinson. The referee, of course, respectfully disagrees. So the Silver Eagles inbound under their own basket. This is Jackson Riley, right side, little left-hand hook, no. O'Donnell with the rebound and the putback for two. Joel O'Donnell draws first blood, and it's a 2-0 MG game. 6:28 to play in the first quarter, and we finally get a basket here. Wendorf to Flannery, looking inside for Latimer. Back to Tordorf. Latimer went strong to the basket, but Riley there to block his path. Tordorf will take the three, short. Rebound O'Donnell. Thomas can't hit the three, rebound Stinson. We got a foul going back the other way. They're going to get Zach Stinson for reaching over the back. Luke Nelson will come in for Stinson. Nelson averaging 3.4 a game. First foul of the game. Tordorf to Latimer. Back to Tordorf. 2-0 MG on top. Tordorf looking for some help. Boy, they really collapse inside. Silver Eagle defense playing really tough. Get it out to Ford. He tries to go right side and had it blocked by Meyer. Now Flannery tries to drive inside to Latimer. Strong to the basket. No. Knocked out of bounds. It's going to be MG ball. They say Latimer touched it last. Latimer's got a good strong move to the basket, but he's got to be able to finish. Now he's going to come out and Weckerly will come in his place. Now Meyer inbounding against the press. Nelson gets the pass, guarded by Ford. He'll bring it up. Thomas, and Thomas is fouled by Noriega. First foul on Noriega, second on Monroe. So Meyer will inbound in front of the rather slight Monroe cheering section. Not a lot of people venturing out tonight in the snow to view this game. Not all the way from Monroe. Miles Thomas, little drive, back off, give it to Nick Meyer. He'll step back, a long two for two. Nick Meyer giving the Silver Eagles a 4-0 lead, 4:45 to play in the first quarter. Flannery walked. Nope. Foul against Joel O'Donnell. First against Joel O'Donnell. Subs coming in for the Silver Eagles. Peyton Miller and Mitchell Kelsey. Miller averaging just under 5 points a game, and like I mentioned, Kelsey in the pregame averaging over six. Silver Eagles can go very deep. Dan Zweifel able to play 9-10 players on a regular rotation. Sub coming in, this is Tyler Elmer, a sophomore, number 23, and also Austin Murphy, a 5'9 senior. So not a lot of height. They play one post player and five guards, basically. Weckerly, no. Rebound Meyer. Silver Eagles with already a big advantage on the boards. Miles Thomas bringing it up the left side for the Silver Eagles. Working against Murphy, give it to Kelsey. Out to Miller for three. Peyton can't get it to drop. Carter Soddy snuck into the game on me. He's a sophomore. He got the rebound and brought it up for Monroe. This is Elmer back to Soddy. Todorf. Todorf averaged 5 points a game last year as a freshman. Currently averaging 8 a game for the Cheesemakers. Elmer. Little spin move, almost lost the handle. Weckerly against Kelsey. They swing it out to Elmer. Weckerly, Todorf. Nice move inside in the first basket of the game. Tyler Elmer doing the honors. 4-2. The Silver Eagle lead cut in half. 3:25 to play in the first quarter. Now Miles Thomas will bring it up for the Silver Eagles. Kelsey left side into the lane. Dump it back to Miller. Top of the key. Thomas left side going baseline. Floats one up. No. Rebound Elmer. Three sophomores on the floor right now for Monroe. This is Elmer to Weckerly. Back to Elmer. Soddy to Murphy. They loop it inside for Weckerly. No foul. Tip in by Elmer, no good. Thomas almost came up with that ball. Now, a foul called against the Cheesemakers. Little slinging elbows there for Todorf. His first foul. Third foul against Monroe. So 2.5 minutes. Subs coming in for the Silver Eagles. Zach Stinson back into the game. O'Donnell, Kelsey, Miller, and Nelson in for the Silver Eagles. Miller from the right corner, no. Kelsey almost came up with that rebound. Elmer corrals it. Ahead to Soddy. Soddy guarded by Peyton Miller. Over to Flannery. Flannery back into the game. This is Weckerly right side. Flannery up top. against Kelsey. Gives it over to Saudi, left side. Now he'll back up on top. Minute 50 to play in the first quarter. 4-2 is all. Saudi stolen by Stinson. Zach in, lays it up, gets the basket and the foul. Stinson's first points of the game. Jacob Flannery called for the foul. Fourth team foul. Now Miller will sit down and Jesus Villagomez coming in for the Silver Eagles. Weckerly will sit, Latimer in. And Desmond Ford also in the game for Monroe. Stinson in tonight's first trip to the free throw line. Can't get it to drop. The Silver Eagles have struggled from the line this year, hitting only 56%. It's a 6-2 MG lead. This is Flannery to Elmer. Elmer into the lane, puts up the 10-footer. No. Went hard after the rebound. Gets tied up with Luke Nelson, and it's MG ball. Next break we get, I'll talk about when these two teams played earlier this season down in Monroe. Stinson getting the inbound pass against some light pressure. Now Desmond Ford will drop off and let him bring it across the timeline. Minute 15 to play in the first quarter. Just a 6-2 game. This is Nelson, left side, driving baseline. Runs out of space. Gives it to Nelson. Villagomez for three. Jesus had it go in and out. Rebound Zach Stinson. Whips it in to Kelsey. Nice pass in. Nelson trying to back in now. Stinson up top. O'Donnell for three. No. Silver Eagles not hitting from the distance. Latimer with the rebound. Now Elmer will walk it up. 40 seconds left in the quarter. Just hand off to Ford. That was kind of clumsy. 30 seconds left. Ford, stop. Oh, hands off to Latimer. Up top to Elmer. Stinson trying to come up with a steal and draws a foul. First foul on Tyler Elmer. Fifth team foul. Now Riley will come in and Villagomez will take a seat. Seconds left in the first quarter, a 6-2 MG lead. Kelsey with the ball for the Silver Eagles, guarded by Flannery. And stolen by Ford, and we got a reach-in foul by Stinson. Stinson's second foul, so I would guess that he's going to sit down for a little while. He will take a seat, and Miles Thomas will come in to play the next 13 seconds of the first quarter. Monroe with their five starters back in the game. Silver Eagles with Thomas, O'Donnell, Riley, Nelson, and Kelsey. Under 8 seconds left. Latimer, Ford. Looking for Noriega. Nope, and a rebound. Thomas in the first quarter ends. A 6-2 Silver Eagle lead. This is reminiscent of the last time these two teams played. The first quarter ended with Monona Grove on top 4-2 before jumping out to an 18-7 halftime lead and then coasting to an easy 39-24 victory in that game. Mitch Kelsey led all scorers with 10 points. Zach Stinson had 8. For Monroe, nobody had more than 5 points. Weckerly and Tordoff each with 5. They scored only 24 points in the whole game. Three quarters, they were held to single digits. In fact, after three quarters, let's see, the score was 26-10. Monona Grove girls playing down at Monroe tonight. Wish them well. That's a long drive when you lose, so I hope they win that one. Earlier tonight, both the JV and the freshmen beat Monroe. Freshmen winning 56-31. JV hanging on to win 43-33. Let's hope the varsity boys can make a clean sweep of things and then The girls do the same thing down south. All right, fresh 8 minutes on the clock, a 6-2 MG lead. We're ready to play. Monroe with the ball for the Silver Eagles. Nelson, Meyer, O'Donnell, Thomas, and Riley. Silver Eagles going nine deep in that first quarter. That's typical for Coach Dan Zwiefel. He's able to go deep with this squad. Very athletic bunch. Dan in his 19th season at Monona Grove. I've had the pleasure of watching all 19. Tordorf to Flannery up top, guarded by O'Donnell. Into the lane, 10-footer, no. Rebound, Nelson. Boy, he out-jumped Latimer on that one. Whereas Latimer is not a jumper. You've seen this kid, he's not a runner either. Nick Meyer, a spin move, no. Tipped up. Slaps the rebound out to Miles Thomas. To Nelson. Nelson looking for a pick from Riley. Monroe picked it up. Now Nelson trying to go baseline. Went to one knee. Out to Riley. To Meyer. Thought about the 18-footer. O'Donnell to Nelson. To Meyer into the lane. Miles Thomas right side. Now he'll dribble up top. Left side to Nelson. To Meyer in the corner. O'Donnell, no. Riley tipping it. Todorf comes up with the ball for Monroe. Silver Eagles with several chances on that possession. Not really great shooting tonight, but really controlling the boards and dominating on defense. Flannery working against O'Donnell. Flannery, second team all-conference linebacker. Not a tall kid, but certainly looks muscular. This is Desmond Ford out to Tordorf. Ford again, right side. No dribble into the lane, runs into trouble. Flannery up top, 6 minutes and a half. Tordorf, a long two, no. Latimer tips it, gets the rebound, goes right back up and is fouled by Riley. He'll go to the line for two. Jackson's first foul, just the fourth team foul against the Silver Eagles. And Latimer to the line for the first time tonight. 5:58 to play in the first half. Latimer hits the first points of the game for Monroe in about 7-8 minutes. Now Peyton Miller will come in and Riley will sit down. Latimer's second shot, no good. Rebound, Meyer. 6-3, the Silver Eagles lead. Peyton Miller bringing it up for Monona Grove and their home whites. Miller left side, up top to Thomas. Swinging around to the left to Kelsey, trying to back in. Now bring it out. They whip it around to Thomas in the left corner. Up top to Miller. They're guarding that three-point shot pretty closely. Like I mentioned, a lot of Silver Eagles can hit that. Meyer missing the 18-footer. Latimer with the rebound. Hung on the rim for a second. Quickly ahead to Tordorf. Tordorf for two. So Monroe back in the game with 3 points in this quarter. 6-5. The Silver Eagles lead is only one. Miles Thomas. Meyer in the right corner to O'Donnell. He'll put up the 18-footer. No. Tipped by Meyer. They'll say he touched it last. It's Monroe ball. Weckerly and Elmer coming back in for the Cheesemakers. Latimer and Flannery will sit down. Weckerly, an honorable mention all-conference baseball player. Ford missing the three. Rebound Stinson. When did Zach sneak back in? O'Donnell into the lane and a foul on the floor. Desmond Ford called for his second foul. They loop it into O'Donnell. Miles Thomas into the lane. Spin move, right-hander. No. Rebound, Weckerly. Monroe with a chance for their first lead of the night. They trail 6-5. Taken out of bounds by Miles Thomas. He intercepted that pass intended for Weckerly. Now Nelson will come in for the Silver Eagles. And Saudi will come in for Monroe. Pair number 12 is checking into the game. Miles Thomas will take a rest. 4.5 minutes to play in the first half. A quick first half. Thordorf looking to inbound finds Saudi. Excuse me, that's Elmer. Guarded by O'Donnell. Interesting matchup, O'Donnell taking on the point guard. Joel, a good defender. They look inside for Weckerly. Swatted out of bounds by Stinson, and we're going to get a foul called. I don't know if they're going to get Zach or Kelsey for that one. Mitch Kelsey called his first. That'll send Weckerly to the line for two. A chance to tie and take the lead. 4:09 to play in the half, a 6-5 MG lead. Weckerly ties it at 6. Monroe student section, all 8 of them pretty excited about that. They haven't seen a lot of ties against a team of MG's caliber. Miss, and Weckerly gets the rebound. Thordorf to Noriega to Elmer. Elmer top of the key, left side. Now Saudi will bring it up top. Elmer has it stripped. O'Donnell with the ball. Fast break, Silver Eagles ahead to Peyton Miller. Peyton puts it up, no. Ball tipped, rebound Stinson, and he traveled with it. Boy, neither offense really getting untracked here tonight. .340 to play in the half, tied at 6. Silver Eagles have yet to score in this quarter. Saudi to Thordorf to Elmer on the left side. Inside to Noriega. He puts up the 8-footer. No, tipped out of bounds by MG. Couple of cheesemakers slapping that one away. Weckerly and Elmer both swatted it out of bounds and took each other out of the play. Now Thordorf and Noriega will sit down. Who came in here? 23, Kevin Murphy, and somebody else. Oh, Flannery came back in. All right, Zach Stinson bringing it up for the Silver Eagles. Let's take the lead here, boys. Peyton Miller left corner. They look inside for Miller. O'Donnell picks up the loose ball. Excuse me, that was Nelson picking up the loose ball, giving it to O'Donnell. Oh, Zach Stinson, 12-footer, no. Knocked out of bounds, it should be, it is, MG ball. Silver Eagles doing everything right except putting the ball in the hole. Stinson inbounds, this is Riley. Miller and Nelson. And a foul going back the other way. Let's see who they got here, I think Jackson Riley, yes it is. Jackson called for his second. So Riley and Stinson each with 2 fouls. And we see Jason Bilkey coming off the bench and into the game, 6'3 senior. Jason averaging just under 2 points a game. He had 4 against Edgewood in that victory last week. Weckerly's fouled by Peyton Miller. Peyton looked incredulous. No, they're not going to call it. They're going to call it on Bilkey. All right, and that'll send Weckerly to the line where he's 1-for-2. Monroe once again the chance to take their first lead of the game. Tied at 6 right now. He does. Cheesemakers go up 7-6. Weckerly's second one coming up. Right there. 8-6. Silver Eagles have been outscored 6-0 in this quarter now. 2:34 left in the half. Bilkey up top to Miller. Into the lane, 10-footer, Peyton Miller. That's more like it. Ties it at 8. First basket of the quarter from Monona Grove. Elmer, 10-footer, he drops one in. It was the first jump shot, I think, of the game that went in. Elmer with 4 points, now to lead all scorers. That's how sad this is, with 2 minutes to play in the half. Nelson tried to hand off to O'Donnell, taken away by Weckerly. 10-8, the Cheesemakers lead, under 2 minutes to play in the half. Saudi to Weckerly to Elmer again. And Elmer's a good-looking player. He likes his hustle. This is Saudi. Back to Elmer. Minute and a half to play. Stolen by Bilkey. And Bilkey is fouled by Saudi. Excuse me, by Elmer. That'll be Elmer's second foul. And so Jason Bilkey to the line for 1-1. All right, Meyer will come in for Nelson. O'Donnell in as well. Thomas and Miller and Bilkey at the line. Jason, a chance to hit a couple free throws and tie this up. We're in the bonus. There we go, drop that baby in. All right, Latimer will come in for Murphy. Latimer and Weckerly on the floor for the first time tonight. Minute 23 left. Jason Bilkey a chance to tie things at 10 here. Nope. Tipped right into the hands of Latimer. 10-9, the Silver Eagles trail. Minute 15 and a half. Todorf to Saudi into the lane. Silver goes all over him, and he's called for the charge. Nope. Called against the Silver Eagles. Jason Bilkey called for his second foul. The basket and the foul for Carter Saudi. So Saudi to the line with a chance for a three-point play. Now Bilkey will sit down. Kelsey in for him, and Nelson will come in for Meyer. Twelve to nine, the Cheesemakers lead Monona Grove. Saudi a chance to cap off the three-point play, and he does. 13-9. Minute 5 to play in the half. Peyton Miller bringing it up for the Silver Eagles. Luke Nelson left side now dribbles towards the free throw line. Kelsey to Thomas. Nelson back to Thomas. Thomas now into the lane, puts up the 10-footer. No. Rebound, Weckerly. Silver Eagles shooting is cold tonight. They should be pounding these guys. Saudi to Todorf. 35 seconds left in the half. Let's hope Coach Dan Zweifel's got some words to fire these boys up. Take the lid off that basket. Now Todorf tied up and a timeout called. Good call by Coach Pat Murphy. 25 seconds left. And a 13-9 Monroe lead. Silver Eagles outscored in this quarter 11-3. Stick around, we're going to have the dance team at halftime. All right, coming out of the timeout, the Silver Eagles have Kelsey, O'Donnell, Thomas, Miller, and Nelson. For Monroe, Latimer, Weckerly, Flannery, Saudi, and Todorf. Todorf will take the inbound pass. Flannery up top against Miller. Saudi drives right side, gets the basket and the foul. Luke Nelson called for his first foul. Saudi to the basket again, a chance for a second three-point play in just a minute or so. Would have thought Monroe would held the ball a little longer there. Saudi completes that one. He has 6 points to lead all scorers. He scored it all in the last minute or so. Now Weckerly will come out and Murphy will come in for Monroe. It's a 15-10 Cheesemaker lead. For a while there, it looked like the Silver Eagles were going to turn this into a whooping. That was a few minutes into the game, but boy, that faded fast. Kelsey, 3 seconds left. He puts one up from the free throw line. No. Rebound Latimer. And the first half ends 15-10. Monroe on top over your Silver Eagles. Stick around and watch the dance team. We'll be back with the second half. I'm Steve Martinelli. Thanks for watching so far. Against the MG pressure. Flannery will bring it up against Joel O'Donnell. Silver Eagles with a huge size advantage. Their rebounding edge has got to be enormous in this game. Nice pass inside to Desmond. Desmond Ford, but knocked out of bounds by the Silver Eagles. Todorf will inbound for the Cheesemakers. Gets it into Latimer. Out to Flannery up top. Ford to Todorf. He'll try to drive into the lane. And a foul on the floor. O'Donnell called for the foul. His second, first team foul of the half. Now Kelsey will come in for Riley. Now Todorf inbounding where he was just a minute ago. Ford for three. Nope, rebound O'Donnell. Thomas bringing it up. Left corner's Kelsey. He'll come up top now and give it to Stinson. Right side, Meyer. Meyer to Thomas, top of the key. Stinson. O'Donnell on the left side thought about the three. Give it to Kelsey, swinging around to Thomas. Back to Stinson, top of the key. Silver Eagles got to find a basket there. Stinson, no. Tipped, Latimer with the rebound. O'Donnell almost slapped it away from him. Noriega recovers it. Ford to Latimer. No, Latimer gets the rebound, puts it back up, gets the basket and the foul. Latimer, a strong move to the basket. And O'Donnell called for his third. Latimer to the line. He's one out of two so far. Makes the three-point play, and it's an 18-9 Monroe lead. Now Michael Tomei in for the first time. O'Donnell will take a seat. Tomei is 6'4 junior. Thomas on the fast break. Puts up the 10-footer for two. Miles Thomas, his first points of the game. 19-11. 6:10 to play in the third quarter. Silver Eagles in a hole here, down by eight. Flannery to Ford. Right side, left side, Todorf. Back to Flannery. Ford now against Zach Stinson. Now left side, Todorf up top to Flannery. Ford for three, knocked it down. Ford, his first basket of the game, makes it a 22-11 Monroe lead. Meyer into the lane, Stinson for three. Long. Tomei almost got it, knocked out of bounds by the Cheesemakers. Coach Zweifel's got to find the mix here to score some points. Meyer will sit down now, and Luke Nelson will come in for the Silver Eagles. Kelsey to Nelson. Looking for some help. Stinson to Thomas into the lane. 12-footer, no. Rebound Tomei, right back up with it. Not gonna count, drop. Rebound Noriega, he's on the run. Loses it to Thomas, gets it back. Scrum on the floor, the ball out of bounds. It's gonna be MG ball. Good hustle there by Miles Thomas. Noriega knocked it out of bounds. Now Noriega will take a seat. Saudi will come in. Thomas bringing it up for the Silver Eagles. Down by 11. They're doubled up by Monroe right now, 22-11. Nelson draws the foul. Todorf. Nelson got a little arm out, and they're calling Todorf for the foul. His second. Coach Pat Murphy mildly miffed. Just the first team foul against the Cheesemakers. Now Nelson trying to inbound, get it in, Luke. finds Tomei for two. Tomei's not scored a lot of points this season. He averages about two a game when he does get in. There's his two for the night. 22-13. This is Saudi working against Stinson. Todorf to Ford. Weckerly in the game now for Latimer. Saudi has it ripped away by Stinson. Quickly ahead to Nelson. Puts it up. Gets the basket and the foul. 3-point play coming up for Luke Nelson. Second foul on Flannery. Nelson's first basket of the game, and it's a good one. Chance to add on to it. 3:46 to play in the third quarter, a 22-15 lead. Hopefully getting cut into just a little bit more here. Thank you, Luke Nelson. Luke completes the three-point play. It's 22-16. Ford against the MG press, running into trouble. Gets rid of it to Saudi. Saudi, nice pass to Weckerly. Weckerly converts. First field goal of the night for Weckerly. He has 5 points. It's 24-16. Silver Eagles can make some ground here. Ah, oh, Nelson lost it out of bounds. That was just unfortunate. Well, Silver Eagles can make up some ground here. They can get back in this game pretty quickly if they can score some points. I mean, already we've scored 7 in the last 3 minutes and 35 seconds now. Jesus Villagomez will come in for Nelson. Jesus, a 6-foot senior. Miller almost got it away from Saudi. And we're going to get a foul called against the Silver Eagles. Mitch Kelsey called for his second. Fifth team foul against the Silver Eagles now. So Monroe will be shooting pretty quick. Elmer inbounding to Weckerly. Back to Elmer, trying to go down the right side. Finds his path blocked, runs into the MG double team. Murphy to Elmer. Inside to Murphy, nice pass. Austin Murphy for two. Elmer made that play with a nice wraparound pass. 26-16 with under 3 minutes to play. Kelsey, 10-footer. Rebound Todorf. Shots just not dropping for the Silver Eagles tonight. Neither team has hit a three-point shot tonight. Weckerly up top to Saudi. 2.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. This is Todorf to Elmer. A couple of sophomores. Oh, and Kelsey fouled Elmer. That's Mitch's third. He'll take a seat. Thomas and O'Donnell will come in. Stinson will also sit down. 2:19 to play in the third quarter. A 26-16 Monroe lead. Todorf kind of wrestled Villagomez off. Todorf to Weckerly in the corner. Out. Almost stolen by Miller, and over and back called. I thought Peyton got a hold of that one. Silver Eagles inbound right in front of the MG student section. 2:05 to play. 10-point Monroe lead still, 26-16. Miller inbound to Villagomez. Left corner, looking inside for Tomei. No. O'Donnell with the putback. O'Donnell with 4 points. He leads the Silver Eagles in scoring and goes to the line after drawing the foul. That's the third foul against Tyler Elmer. So O'Donnell, the leading scorer with 4 points. All sorts of cheesemakers coming in now. Ford, Noriega, Flannery, Latimer coming in. Now O'Donnell, his first trip to the free throw line. Come on, Joel. There we go. Three-point play complete. Five for Joel. It's a 26-19 game with under 2 minutes to play in the third. Saudi bringing it up for the Cheesemakers. Lead down to seven. They led by 11 at one point, 22-11. Winona Grove battling back here. Flannery to Noriega to Saudi. And a foul. Peyton Miller called for his first foul. That's got to put us in the bonus pretty quick here, I would think. Now, Villa Gomez will come out and Nelson will come in. Flannery inbounding for the Cheesemakers right in front of his own bench. Gets it into Latimer. Latimer hands off to Ford. Minute and a half to play in the quarter. Saudi into the lane, dumps it down low to Latimer, and Latimer lays it up and in. Latimer with 7 points now. He had one in the first half, 28-19. Excuse me, Miller to Nelson for three. Nope. Oh! And Tome submarined. He's okay, though. Both players okay. But that's going to be a foul. Foul on Flannery, his third. He looked like a linebacker on that one. Miller inbounding to Nelson. No foul there. O'Donnell for three. No. Joel hustling after the rebound. Now they call the foul on O'Donnell. He's saying he had nothing but ball. I think that's the fourth on Joel O'Donnell. Yes, it is. Now he'll have to come out. Nelson will take a seat as well. Simpson and Meyer into the game. 55 seconds left in the third quarter. It's a 28-19 Monroe lead. Tordorf will come in and Noriega will sit down. Weckerly into the game for Monroe. Tordorf to Ford to Latimer. Latimer for two. Latimer with 8 points. 30-19, back to an 11-point lead. Stinson to Miller, left side. Miller trying to go baseline, step back, hit Thomas on top. Miles across the free throw line, put up a jump shot, no. Tip by O'Donnell, rebound by Miles Thomas. He'll put it up and in. It gets called for the charge. Oh, I don't know if I agree with that one. Miles Thomas called for his first foul there. Now 13 seconds left in the third quarter. They go down low to Latimer again, and he lays it up again. Latimer in double figures now. 32-19, biggest lead of the night. Thomas. Can't get it to drop, and the third quarter ends. The Silver Eagles struggling. 32-19 versus the Monroe Cheesemakers. Yikes. We came into this game thinking that they should win by a pretty fair margin, as they outclass Monroe in every category, but Monroe with some fight in that dog. I mentioned Silver Eagle girls are playing down in Monroe tonight. Friday night, both these teams, boys and girls, are in action again. The boys will be playing away at DeForest, and we'll have the girls here against Wanakee. girls travel the following day, this Saturday, for an afternoon game at Milwaukee King. And then they're back here for a home game on the 10th, Tuesday night, against the Edgewood Crusaders. Right now, though, the boys got to get something going. 8 minutes left in this game, and they trail at 32-19. Biggest lead of the night for the Cheesemakers. And my wife is texting me cat pictures. Nice distraction during a game where we're not playing well. Silver Eagles down by 13 points now, entering the fourth quarter. Not insurmountable, but they got to fight an uphill climb. They got to find a way to keep the ball out of Latimer's hands. They're getting too many easy baskets underneath for the big guy. He just kind of patrols that baseline. Ford to Latimer. Latimer to the hoop. Gets the basket and the foul. Latimer using his size and Meyer called for his first foul. Latimer to the line where he's 2 out of 3. Now Tomei will go out and O'Donnell will come back in. Remember O'Donnell with 4 fouls. Latimer missing that one. O'Donnell with the rebound. Latimer with 12 points now. Thomas down the floor in a hurry. Hand off to Luke Nelson. Nelson, left hand scoop. No, but draws a foul and will get 2 shots. 34-19, the biggest lead of the night. Let's see if Luke can cut into this a little. Foul called against Flannery, his 4th. Flannery with 4 fouls, no points. Luke's first trip. No, he made a free throw earlier to complete a 3-point play. Nails this one as well. Now the free throw shooting has improved. Nelson's second one coming up. Nelson hits them both. That makes it a 34-21 Monroe lead. Full court pressure now. Weckerly tipped into the hands of Meyer. Falling away. Stinson with the rebound. Stinson with the basket and the foul. Tough, tough play inside by Meyer and Stinson. Zach getting the basket. Foul on Kevin Noriega, his 2nd. Stinson's 2nd field goal free throw attempt. Both of them missed. Out of bounds. It's going to be Monroe ball. 34-23, back to that 11-point lead for the Cheesemakers. They have the ball. 7:16 to play. Noriega against the pressure. Out of bounds. MG gets it. And a timeout called by Coach Murphy of the Cheesemakers. Noriega got tied up and then lost it out of bounds, and so the Silver Eagles will get the ball under their own basket, trailing by 11, 7:13 to play in the game. Both teams in the bonus, so free throws could play a big part in this. Really, the Silver Eagles struggling on offense like I haven't seen them this year. Their low for the season is 39 points when they beat Monroe before. How about that? It's the only time they've been held below 40 all season. In fact, that's the only time they've been held below 45 all season. Let's hope we can reverse that tonight. Remember, the Silver Eagles beat Monroe in a low-scoring game, 39-24. When was that? Friday, December 19th. Well, let's hope we can turn things around here. Now Stinson will inbound for the Silver Eagles. Stinson. Finds Miles Thomas up top to Nicholas Myers. Thought about the long two. He'll give it off to Thomas. Back to Meyer. Thomas to Nelson. And Nelson called for the travel. Now Tordorf inbounding on the side. Under 7 minutes left in the game and a 11-point Monroe lead. A couple good possessions. We could get right back in this one. Need to get a defensive stop. Keep it out of Latimer's hands. Myers harassing him. And they took too much time. Did Murphy get the timeout? It appears he did. Timeout called, so it'll be Monroe ball off on the side here. Good call by Coach Pat Murphy, knowing that clock was about to expire and turn it over. And now the obligatory thunderstruck. I think you're required to play AC/DC at most high school sporting events. Although skiing is a hard one to play AC/DC to. All right, 6:47 to play. Tordorf inbound for the Silver Eagles. They've got Stinson, Thomas, Miller, Nelson, and O'Donnell. All good shooters on the floor. This is Ford against Stinson. Runs into Miller. Tordorf triple teamed, and he's fouled. I think they'll get Miller. Yep. Peyton Miller called for his second foul, and that'll send Tordorf to the line. Tordorf's first trip to the line. He's got 2 points. Tordorf knocks that one down, earns another one. Good free throw shooting by the Cheesemakers. 35-23, a 12-point lead. Tordorf, nothing but net on that one. 36-23. Stinson in a hurry. Kick it back to Miller, top of the key. Right side Miller, or excuse me, Nelson to Thomas. To Stinson, three ball, no. Latimer almost got it. Nelson picks it up. Thomas for three, no. Rebound, Miller. O'Donnell trying to go baseline against Latimer. Kick it out to Nelson for three. There we go. Luke Nelson with 8 points. 36-26. Let's get a stop now, boys. Tordorf to Noriega to Ford. Tordorf on top. Almost lost the handle. Floats one up. Blocked by O'Donnell. Thomas picks up the loose ball on the run. Nice pass down low to Miller. Couldn't handle it, though. Off to Stinson. Two for Zach. And a timeout called. Stinson with 6 points now. 36-28. The Silver Eagles fighting back now. Trail it by only eight with 5:35 to play. Like I mentioned, a lot of game left here. Silver Eagles on a 9-4 run. Nothing too noteworthy, but they get a stop at another basket here, and we're making this a real challenge for the Cheesemakers. Silver Eagles using their size and athleticism to get back in this one. If they can find a way to stop Latimer, the big junior with 12 points, most of them, well, 10 of them, on easy, soft touch baskets in the paint. All right. Monroe will inbound at the MG end of the court. MG press now. They get it into Ford. Back to Tordorf to Noriega. He runs into the double team. Noriega dribbles out of it now. Goes to the hoop and draws the foul and will get two shots. Foul on Stinson, his third. Remember, he had two fouls early in the first quarter. That's Only the third on him now. Noriega to the line. He is scoreless tonight, averaging a little over 6 points a game. Noriega, a senior. Sinks that one. Monroe is hitting their free throws, and they need to if they're going to hold on to this one. Now O'Donnell in for Meyer. Weckerly in for Latimer. We haven't seen Jackson Riley in a while. I don't know if we've seen him in this half. Jackson with two fouls. I'm not sure what's up with him. Noriega hits them both. Boy, they are deadly from the line tonight. 38-28. Let's hit one here, boys. Miller with the ball. Left, right side, Stinson. Dump it down low to O'Donnell, and he gets fouled and we'll get two shots. So it's turning into a game from the free throw line. Third on Noriega. O'Donnell to the line where he's one out of one. 5 points on the evening for the junior. Ah. Gotta make your free throws, guys. Come on, Joel. There we go. 6 points for Joel, a 38-29 game. Now Elmer will come in for Noriega. .514 to play in this one. A 9 point Monroe lead and a foul on Miller. That'll send Tord off to the line. Third foul on Peyton. Tordorf, 2 out of 2 from the line, 4 points total. Misses that one. That gives us a break. 5:12 to play in the game. Tordorf coming up with the second one as they're in the double bonus. Makes that one. 5 points now for Tordorf. Back to a 10-point lead for the Cheesemakers. Silver Eagles can't quite get over that hump. Thomas to Nelson. Trying to go baseline, looking for help, dump it into O'Donnell. Turnaround move, nice play by Joel O'Donnell. Joel has 8 points, 39-31. Weckerly to Saudi. Saudi's nice pass to Ford. Ford finishes. Ford with 5 points, a 41-31 lead. Like I'm saying, they just can't get in there. O'Donnell into the lane, no foul called on Weckerly. Jump ball call, and it goes to the Silver Eagles. Geez, O'Donnell went in, and he and Weckerly collided, and Weckerly went down. I thought a foul should have been called on somebody, but no whistle. Weckerly's coming out, and Latimer back in. Stinson inbounding for the Silver Eagles to O'Donnell. Up top to Miller. Dump it out to O'Donnell, left corner. 10-footer, no. Who wants the rebound? Tordorf comes up with it. Silver Eagles just can't catch a break here. Oh, that was kind of a ticky-tack foul called on Peyton Miller, his fourth. And that'll send Saudi to the line where he's 2 for 2 already. 4:12 in the game and a 10-point Monroe lead, 41-31, and a chance to add a couple more here for Saudi. Noriega in for Ford. Carter Saudi up to the line. Saudi with 7 points already and a chance for another one here. 8 points for the sophomore, 43-31. Miller for three, no, rebound Latimer. They lose it, Nelson recovers, Thomas for three, short, Latimer with the rebound, fell right into his lap, Saudi on the break now, lays it up, Saudi for two. It's starting to slip away now. A 14-point lead for the Cheesemakers. Stinson to Miller. Miller to O'Donnell, 10-footer. No, rebound Todorf. Nobody there from the Silver Eagles to go after that one. They're all standing around watching. Noriega ahead to Latimer. Stolen by Miller. Latimer lollygagged that one, and Miller in to take advantage of it. Stinson into the lane. A charge, come on. I don't know about this refereeing crew. I've seen some calls both directions that have been somewhat questionable. That's the fourth foul on Zach Stinson now. Well, Villa Gomez will come in. Meyer will come in. Stinson and Miller will sit down. .317 to play, a 14-point Monroe lead, 45-31. Noriega into the double team, gets it out to Ford. Ford across the timeline into the corner to Latimer. Latimer up top to Tordoff. 3:05 to play. Into the hands of Nelson. Luke will lay it up for two. And a timeout called by the Silver Eagles. Luke Nelson with 10 points. Luke with a career-high 10 points. His best was 8 against Milton. He just broke that with that layup. A 12-point Monroe lead with 2:57 to play. Still not out of reach of the Silver Eagles. 45-33. I got to start hitting some shots, though. Boy. I'm curious what's up with Jackson Riley. We haven't seen Jackson at all in the second half. All right, coming out of the timeout, it's Nelson, Villa Gomez, Meyer, O'Donnell, and Thomas. A couple Silver Eagles with foul trouble. O'Donnell playing with four. Now, he's up against Tordorf on the press here. Ford and Meyer run into each other, and that'll send Ford to the line for two. Nick Meyer called for his second foul. Ford to the line for the first time. He's got 5 points already. Miller and Stinson ready to come in. Ford hits that one. Now O'Donnell and Meyer will take a rest. So the Silver Eagle basically with an all-guard lineup here. Stinson, Miller, Nelson, Villa Gomez, and Thomas. They take Latimer out, so they respond with an all-guard lineup of their own. Flannery, Noriega, Ford, Saudi and Tordoff. Rebound Nelson. Ford misses the second one. 46-33. Miller for three. No. Miles Thomas with the rebound. Villa Gomez for three. He can't get it. Saudi with the rebound. Looking for some help. Now runs into a double team. Stolen by Stinson. Ahead to Nelson. Another layup for Lucas. Nelson, a career high 12 points. 46-35. And a foul called. Ah, this might be Peyton Miller's fifth. And he will sit down and Mitch Kelsey will come in. Peyton Miller will foul out with 2 points. Mitch Kelsey into the game now for the Silver Eagles. Carter Saudi to the line where he's a perfect 4-for-4, a 46-35 lead with 2:20 to play in the game. Saudi's hit 5 in a row from the line. Second free throw is good. 15 points for Carter Soddy. 48-35. Nelson can't get it to drop. Rebound Tordorf. 2:10 to play. Tordorf will dribble out of the trouble. Off to forward right side. Back to Noriega. Timeout called by the Cheesemakers. Noriega got ran into the double team and needed a timeout from his coach. Now, minute 59 to play. Things starting to get a little dire for the Silver Eagles as they trail by 13, 48-35. The Cheesemakers, after a slow start in that first quarter, they only scored 2 points. They've come on strong and been in double figures every quarter since. And really doing a great job from the free throw line. That's where they've really shown, and that's making the difference here in the fourth quarter. They maintained that 13-point lead. Silver Eagles got to find some magic. They got to get some defensive stops and make a couple baskets here. All right, Kelsey, Thomas, Nelson, Stinson, and Meyer for the Silver Eagles. Weckerly, Soddy, Ford, Tordorf, and Noriega for the Cheesemakers. They get it into Noriega. Back to Weckerly. Tordorf to Weckerly. Silver Eagles double teaming every chance they get. Ford to Noriega, back to Weckerly. They're just playing a little keep away right now. And they throw it away. Keep away turned into throw it away. Silver Eagle ball with a minute 39. Thomas to inbound. Villa Gomez will come in for Meyer. All shooters on the floor. Minute 39. Stinson, Villa Gomez, to Kelsey. Back to Villa Gomez, trying to go left side, fall away jumper. Good for Jesus. 48-37 with a minute 25 to play. Now the double team ties him up. And Ford will go to the line. Foul on Jesus Villa Gomez. Forward to the line where he's 1 out of 2, 6 points on the night. He gets 2 free throws here as we're in the double bonus. Boy, the gym got really quiet there. Ford misses that one. An 11-point lead for the Cheesemakers. They're not used to being in this position as they've not won a lot of games this year. Ford missed them both. Rebound Kelsey. Silver Eagles a chance to get it under 10. Villa Gomez to Kelsey for three. Can't get it. Rebound Stinson. Cross court to Villa Gomez. Right side, Lucas Nelson for three. No in and out. Rebound Kelsey, and he's fouled. Kelsey fouled by Flannery, and that should do it for Flannery. Flannery with his 5th foul, no points on the night. He'll take a seat, and Weckerly will come in to take his place. And Mitch Kelsey to the line. Kelsey averaging 6.4 a game. He's scoreless tonight. This is a big couple of free throws for him as he can get it down to a 9-point deficit with a minute 4 left. Weckerly in, O'Donnell in for Villa Gomez. Joel with 4 fouls, remember, as is Zach Stinson. All right, Mitchell Kelsey. Perfect on that one. 48-38 with a minute 4. Kelsey's 2nd attempt coming up. Latimer coming in for Ford.
Get that rebound.
All right. Kelsey hits them both. Just a 9-point game now. Weckerly inbounds to Tordorf. Tordorf called for the travel. Thomas and O'Donnell doing a great job pinning him in the corner. And Tordorf called for the travel. Now Weckerly will come out and Ford will come back in. The Silver Eagles with the ball under their own basket. This will be Zach Stinson with a minute left. Just a 9-point lead for Monroe. Stinson's inbound to Kelsey. Over to Nelson. Into the lane. Dump it back to Thomas for three. Miles can't get it to go. And Stinson gets fouled and will go to the line. Foul called on Desmond Ford, his third. Stinson to the line. He has 6 points, but he's 0 for 2 from the line. A couple of big ones here with 53 seconds left. And Stinson hits that one, earns another 7 points for the senior captain. 48-40. This is the closest we've been in a while. See if Zach can bring us even a bit closer. Nope. Rebound Saudi. Into the press and fouled by Miles Thomas. Thomas called for his second. No, O'Donnell called for that one. That's his fifth, so he'll sit down. Jesus Villagomez will come in. Toward off to the line where he's 3 out of 4. 48 seconds left in the game. Starting to look bad if Tordorf can hit these. There's the first. Tordorf with 6 points. 49-40. And Elmer will come in for Latimer as they go to the small lineup again. 5 guards. Both teams with shooters on the floor. Tordorf makes that one too. That's going to cause a problem. 50-40 with 45 seconds left. Stinson down the floor in a hurry. Villagomez for three. Nailed it! And a timeout called. Silver Eagles down the floor in a hurry and a nice pass from Stinson to Villagomez, and Jesus nailed it. He's got 5 points now and it's back to a 7-point lead. 50-43. 41 seconds remaining. This one's far from over. These last 40 seconds can take a while now. All right, Nick Meyer checking in for the Silver Eagles, joining Nelson, Thomas, Stinson, and Kelsey. Latimer in for Monroe. Kelsey will hang back and cover the big man. See what the MG press can do now. Tordorf inbounding. Oh, and Saudi lost it out of bounds. So the Silver Eagles with a chance, 38 and a half seconds left. Meyer will sit down and Villagomez will come in. Latimer down and Elmer in. Silver Eagles. It's a 7-point game so far. Let's see what they can do here. To Thomas, 8-footer. No, not another charge against Thomas. Come on. Miles Thomas called for his second foul. That's a bad foul. That's just a bad call. No. 35 seconds left, and that hurts. 35 seconds left. We had a good possession there, and I thought Miles made it and drew the foul, in fact. Tordorf getting mugged, and they don't call anything. I don't know where this official crew came from. Oh, mercy. That's the fifth foul against Zach Stinson. Mark, Now Trey Powers coming in for Myers. Carter Saudi to the line, where he's a perfect 6 out of 6 and can lock this one up, I'm afraid. 28 seconds left and a 50-43 Monroe lead. Hey, Saudi hit that one. You know, I don't want to make it sound like the referees made a difference in the game tonight. Silver Eagles are not shooting the ball well, but there's been some really funky calls here. Saudi. Perfect. 8 out of 8 from the line. He has 14 points. That's a 9-point lead. Powers for 3. No. Tordorf with the rebound. Ooh, Villagomez went down hard. Now Elmer goes down hard. Tordorf gets the layup. That's going to do it, folks. 10 seconds left. Villagomez for 3. Villagomez hitting one, falling away. 54-46. Elmer, and that's going to do it. 54-46. The Cheesemakers have upset the Silver Eagles. Disappointing night on a game that Monona Grove should have used to get their 12th win of the season. Instead, they end up losing 54-46. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Monona Grove Silver Eagle Basketball. I'm Steve Martelli. We'll be back here Friday night when the girls take on Wanakee. Thanks a lot.